It's Trial Tuesday, and we are joined now by none other than Attorney David Aylor. How are you?
I'm doing well.
Happy Valentine's Day, David.
Happy Valentine's Day to you as well.
You're so kind. All right, we're talking about employment today and some legal advice that you have for some people trying to get jobs. First of all, let's talk about employment discrimination.
Well, a lot of times with employment discrimination, you know, it's something that people feel or suspect that they feel, but they don't actually know it. You know, they don't know it for sure, or should I say, they can't exactly prove
it. They can't prove it.
Exactly.
Right. When you talk about proving it, though, I find that oftentimes that's somebody's problem. They say, I know that it happened to me, but what do I do to explain it to you as an attorney? What should they do?
Well, you know, things like emails, documentation of it, other witnesses, things like that are going to be what can help you the most. When someone's left a job or maybe been let go from a job, if they have other people that can, you know, help really supplement what their beliefs are.
Right.
Usually, of course, paperwork, that sort of thing would be the best. But if not, if there's other people that have worked there currently or in the past, it can also help provide further detail. You know, otherwise, it's really tough to just put it out there on your own.
Right. What about pregnant women that they find themselves going on maternity leave and then they, you know, they come back the 6 or 7 or 8 weeks later and they feel like either their job is gone and they've just been put in kind of this supplemental role and they're going to be phased out? That type of thing. I know you hear about that all the time.
Right. And I think that's something you have to be made aware of ahead of time and really try to pay attention to, you know, exactly what your position is and if that is coming, to try to make sure you don't make yourself indisposable. And in that, you know, if it is going to be there, you make sure you're documented on what you're doing and when you come back, what your position will still be.
Okay. Still talking about employment, but social media when it comes to your employment. How much trouble can you really get into from things that you say on Facebook and Twitter?
Well, it starts with getting hired. A lot of times people right now look at when they have an application or do an interview, they'll go online and they look to see if they can find someone on you know, Facebook, Twitter, that sort of thing. And you may not get a job because of something you say on there. And then after actually having a job, someone may let you go and not even, you might not know it because it's something you're putting on your Facebook account or your Twitter account. And it may not be something they really should even be looking at and letting you go for that reason, but they do. Political beliefs, religious beliefs, that sort of thing.
Right. And speaking of, a very prominent anchor on a very prominent news station just was suspended for something that he said on Twitter, and he didn't think there was anything wrong with it. And then all of a sudden he's suspended and there's nothing you can do about it. I mean, people just need to be careful.
Absolutely. I mean, and in fact, in that case specifically, it didn't really seem that controversial per se.
At the time, right.
Right. But for his company, they decided that's what it was, and that was his personal Twitter account.
Right.
And again, that's a perfect example of something, you know, on the national level where look what happened after just him putting out something from his personal account.
Right. So what do you suggest then? Because, I mean, I know that some of us have work accounts and we have personal accounts. Maybe lock it down as best you can and just hope that, or maybe just when in doubt, leave it out.
Yeah, exactly. When in doubt, leave it out, because even if it's your personal account, it sometimes can be then communicated to someone else outside of your personal friends and relatives, that sort of thing.
Right.
But in general, you do want to have a separation. A lot of times people will get in trouble just because they may have something on their work account that is something in their personal life and they let it out that way, and then it relates back to the company they work for and there's even more trouble there.
There you go. Well, when in doubt, leave it out. You like that?
I like that.
I'm a poet and don't know it.
There you go.
Happy Valentine's Day. It was funny. We'll be back in just a little bit. Stay with us. It was hilarious. You can laugh.